Hello? Until I feared I would lose it, I never loved to read. One does not love breathing. Harper Lee, To Kill a Mockingbird. In this quote, Harper Lee's character, Scout, compares reading to breathing. This is how necessary it has become in this character's life. Now, I know what you're all thinking. It's just one person, and she's kind of fictional. And if that's the case, then I urge you to think again, because there are many, many more of us than you think, and we are very real, thank you very much. Take me for an example. I spend every waking moment thinking about what I should next be reading or writing, and the mere thought of being incapable of partaking in either of these activities for a single day makes me want to crawl into a corner and die. I can no longer count how many books that I've read, and it pains me that there might not be enough time in this life to read everything that I want to. Fellow bookworms, students, judges, I am not here today to talk to you about a word or a topic or a thesis. I'm here to talk to you about a way of life. As one of the aforementioned book lovers, it is my sincere belief that books are better than people, and though you may not agree with me right now, I hope that you will at least be reflecting upon this by the time I finish with my speech. For one thing, books will not judge you or stab you in the back, unlike people. It should also be noted that they can't grow legs and walk away from you, so they will always be there for you. Lastly, the language that is used to craft these stories is simply beautiful and eloquent in its complexity and diversity, completely unlike everyday conversations with your bestie. Firstly, books are better than people because they won't judge you or stab you in the back, something that people seem to have a hard time not doing. Since books are also incapable of speaking, and no, Tom Riddle's journal does not count, there's no way that your secrets will come to light should you choose to confide in them. Which brings me to my second point. Books will always be there for you. Now you can go right on ahead and say that your best friend would never let you down, but let's be honest here. If it's 3 o'clock in the morning and you can't sleep and you decide to call your best friend, I don't think they will be overly pleased with you unless they have no need for sleep or are a full-fledged nocturnal human. Books, however, have no schedule. They don't have to do homework or go visit family or go to Disney World over the Christmas vacation and leave you alone with the only human that you are. With their inspirational stories and characters, books are a great way to make you feel like you have friends again. Ultimately, there would be no story without words, and that, my friends, is just another dab of sweet icing on the already sugar-coated gargantuan cake of books. I know you'll probably call me boring for saying this, but one of the reasons that I personally find reading so appealing is the use of language. Think back to the last conversation you had. Was it with your mom, your dad, your best friend, some random stranger who's willing to listen to you complain? Either way, I'm pretty sure you did not use words such as erstwhile, or wherein, or mayhap. If you didn't, that's just one of the many reasons that the English language is slowly dying. More and more words are floating up from the pages of our beloved books and being blown into oblivion because people seem to simply not care anymore. With that being said, I urge you to seriously think over the consequences of our actions should we cease to read entirely. I will say it once more, it is my firm and absolute belief that books are better than people because they won't judge you or stab you in the back. They won't hound you if you make bad life decisions and will accept you with open pages. They will also always be there for you, and the language that is used to craft these stories is completely unlike everyday conversations, which normally contain like a lot of likes. I know you're probably sick and tired of hearing me babble on about books, yes. But before you decide that you don't believe as I do, I would like to give you one last thing to think about. Do you seriously want to be the reason behind the downfall of the English language?